Well, welcome to Children's Tuesday Time with Pastor Emily. And first of all, I just want to say how much I miss seeing you in person. I really, really miss you. And since we can't be together right now because we are sheltering in place, and in order to love our neighbor as ourselves and to make sure that all of our neighbors, including ourselves, are healthy and safe, I wanted to make sure that we could have some time to gather once a week for a Bible story and to pray together and to think about an activity we can do together. So as we begin every single time together, we're going to light a candle as a reminder that God loves us, that God's light is with us wherever we go, and that we are not alone. So I'm going to teach you what we're going to say at the very beginning of every time together as we light the candle. So I'm going to teach it to you, and then we're going to do it as we light the candle. So what we're going to say, and you can repeat after me, we're going to open our arms and say, God's holy light surrounds us. So why don't you say that after me? God's holy light surrounds us. Only good can come in. So when you put your hands in, you're going to go, only good can come in, only good can go out. Amen. All right, so let's try that together as we light our candle. As a reminder that God is in this place with us right now. God is shining God's light and love to us. God loves us, and we are not alone. God's holy light surrounds us. Only good can come in. Only good can go out. Amen. So we're going to start today by reading a story. It's from the Children of God Storybook Bible, which are the Bible stories rewritten by Archbishop Desmond Tutu. And today we're going to read a story called The Creation from Genesis 1. It's the first of two creation stories in our Bible. In the very beginning, God's love bubbled over when there was nothing else. No trees, no birds, no animals, no sky, no sea. Only darkness. Out of this love, God spoke, "Let there be light." And there was day, and there was night. And when the first day was done, God smiled and knew that it was good. On the second day, God said, "Let there be sky where the clouds can float and the wind can blow." And the sky was bright blue and it was beautiful. How many of you have seen the sky blue and beautiful? On the third day, God said, "Let the waters gather together into oceans and let the dry land appear." Now God decided to make the world even more dazzling with tall trees and long grass. And then the first flower opened in all its glory. How many of you have seen some flowers lately and seen them open in all their glory? On the fourth day, God said, "Let the sky be filled with the sun and the moon." And God scattered stars across the sky like sparkling diamonds. Have you seen the sky filled with stars and they looked like diamonds? On the fifth day, God said, "Let there be birds to fly and to sing, and fish to swim and splash." And the world was filled with the joyous sound of bird song. Do you like the sound of the birds singing? I love the sound of the birds singing. On the sixth day, God said, "Let there be animals, elephants and giraffes, cats and mice, and bees and bugs." And suddenly, the world was a very noisy place. But something was still missing. Then God said, "I will make people, and I'll make them like me, so they can enjoy the earth and take care of it." Wow, we've got a big responsibility to take care of the earth. God did just as God had said, and it was all so very, very good. God looked at everything that God had made, and God clapped God's hands together in delight. Isn't it wonderful? And on the seventh day, God laughed and rested and enjoyed God's glorious creation. I love to think about God laughing and resting and enjoying all of God's creation, including all of us. So one of the things that we'll do each week is to come up with a couple activities, one or two activities to do for the rest of the week until we meet again next week. And so this week, I'm going to encourage you to do two different activities. I want you to take some time, whether you go on a walk, or if you get a chance to look out your window, or maybe you get to sit outside if you have a yard, or whatever it might be. I want you to take some time this week, when you're looking outside or if you are outside, to look around you at the trees or the grass or rocks, or maybe it's a sunset, or maybe it's the moon or the sun. Maybe it's the birds that you hear in the air, if you hear birds chirping or see them flying, or maybe you hear dogs barking. I want you to take some time to look around in the nature, in God's creation, and find three things that you see or hear that are beautiful and remind you of God's love and God's goodness. And then I want you to tell your family members, whether it's a sibling or your parents or guardian, somebody that you live with, what those three things are that you found in nature this week that were good and reminded you of God's beauty and goodness. For example, I love watching the sunset. So last week I got a chance to look out my window and to see the sunset, and it reminded me of God's beauty and God's love for me. And I also love sitting in this room, and I can hear a lot of the birds chirping in the tree behind me that you can see out my window. And that reminded me so much of God's love and goodness. So I encourage you to do that. The second activity I encourage you to do this week is, we have been given, as we heard in our story today, a big responsibility. As God's children and as humans, we have been given the responsibility by God to take care of God's earth and all of the creatures and living things on God's earth. So I want you to sit down sometime with your family members and come up with something that you can do together. If you're with someone right now, I want you to look at them right now and come up with one or two things you can do this week to take care of God's earth and creation. Whether it's, if you have an animal at home, maybe you help feed that animal or walk the animal if that animal needs to be walked, or maybe helping them feel comfortable, whatever it might be. Maybe it's to make sure all the lights are turned off when you're not in a room and using the lights. Maybe it's to help recycle so that we make sure that we limit the amount of things we throw away. Maybe it's to plant a flower in your garden, or if you have, if you can get some herbs and put them in a sunroom or next to a window in your home. Come up with one or two things that you can do as a family together this week to care for God's creation. So if you're sitting with someone else right now, take this time to talk about that. What might you do? Let us pray. As we pray, I just invite you to take a deep, slow breath in and breathe out slowly. And as you breathe in, let's breathe in. Imagine breathing in the love of God, filling your lungs with God's love and compassion. And breathe out slowly. Try to release all the things that are bothering you or upsetting to you right now onto God, because God cares for you. Let's do that one more time. Let's breathe in together slowly. Breathing in the love and breath of God, and breathe out slowly, releasing all the things that are bothering you or upsetting you today onto God, because God cares for you. Dear God, we thank you for loving each of us so much and loving all of your creation that you created very, very good. Help us, God, to enjoy and to care for your beautiful earth. Amen. I wanted to read to you, before we sing our song together, a letter from Archbishop Desmond Tutu, who rewrote these stories, these Bible stories. And this is a letter to each one of you. Dear child of God, do you know that God loves you? Did you know that? The Bible says that each and every single one of us is a very, very special person. God says, before you were born, I knew you. God made you just as you are so you could be your own unique and precious gift to the world. God made every one of us different, but God loves all of us equally, for we are all God's children. And no matter what happens, God will never stop loving you. God also wants us to fill our lives with love. Jesus says we should love God. We should love other people, our neighbors and others. And we should also love ourselves. How do we do this? By doing three important things. By doing what is right. By being kind to one another. And by being friends with God. God bless you, Archbishop Desmond Tutu. So as a reminder of that, as we listened to our story, we were reminded that God said, "Let there be light," and there was light, and it was good. We are reminded as we lit our candle today that God's love and light is with us always, that we are beloved children of God. God loves us and cares for us so much, that God is with us always. And so we're going to sing a song. Some of you may know this song as a reminder of that, that God's light is with us, but also that God gives us God's light and love to shine to our neighbors and to those around us. So let's go ahead and sing. If you want to get up and sing and dance, you are welcome to. So we're going to go ahead and you can follow my actions. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Jesus gave me the light, I'm gonna let it shine. Jesus gave me the light, I'm gonna let it shine. Jesus gave me the light, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Everywhere I go, everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Let's hear you really loudly now. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Very good. So just remember that God's light is with you always, that God's love is with you, that God loves you, God cares for you, and that you are not alone. I hope that you can take this week to really enjoy God's creation around you. And maybe you can share with me somehow. You can send me an email, or you can make a comment in Facebook or on YouTube, something that you found this week in God's creation that was beautiful and reminded you of God's love. So we're going to do our ritual that we will always do as we close together. We're going to hold this candle. We're going to do the same thing that we did as we began, but at the very end, we'll have a little extra thing to say. So I'm going to teach it to you, and then we're going to do it together. God's holy light surrounds us. So you're going to say, God's holy light surrounds us. Only good can come in. So when we do this, you say, only good can come in. Only good can go out. Only good can go out. And then we're going to say, we carry this light wherever we go. Amen. All right. So that last part is, we carry this light wherever we go. Amen. All right, so let's do that together. God's holy light surrounds us. Only good can come in. Only good can go out. We carry this light wherever we go. Amen. I will see you next week.